This video is about something that has intimidated me for several years, dimpling chainstays. It's easy to dent a tube, but it's hard to do it repeatably and smoothly, especially with titanium. Titanium is notoriously difficult to work with. It springs back a lot more than steel and can crack or buckle if it's cold work too much. If you don't know, chainstay dimples are used to provide tire and drivetrain clearances. In my designs, I typically design for a 6mm deep dimple. Any more, and I like to use a 3D printed chainstay yoke. This is just my personal preference. Some builders will use annealed chainstays for titanium to get more clearance, or they will dimple the outside of the chainstay to clear the chainring. I was afraid to tackle this tube dimpling problem because it always seemed more art than science. However, it was only a recent trip to ORA Engineering in Taiwan that I discovered some secrets. If one of the best factories in the world converged on this method, it probably works pretty well. The key feature of the ORA design was the pivoting support block. As you form the tube, the support block pivots out of the way, preventing a flat spot or ridge on the backside of the tube. I was able to replicate their design using 40mm T-slot extrusion, a few blocks of acetyl, and laser-cut steel brackets. In total, this project was less than $200, and I will put a link to the custom frame forum with a more detailed write-up and parts list. I initially tried 3D printing the support blocks, but they cracked under the pressure, just like me making YouTube videos. I ended up hand machining the blocks out of acetyl. The most challenging part of the design was the dimple die. Going into this project, I had no idea of the ideal shape, material, and the size of this die. There are two schools of thought: indenting the tube with a narrow die or squishing the tube with a cylinder. I couldn't decide which one was better, so I averaged both designs and created a mega dimple die. At first, we tried hand shaping the acetyl die. It produced decent results, as you can see here. However, if you look closely, the dimple was a bit uneven. This was likely due to my lack of patience and sketchy craftsmanship when forming the die. I think a hand-shaped die would be good enough for 90% of people. Unfortunately, I hold myself to too high standards, so I sent a CNC design to PCBWay for a quote. I got quotes for both plastic and steel, and was surprised to find a giant chunk of steel was the same price. So obviously, I went with steel because it is real. I was honestly surprised how good the results were. The fixture works really well. The dimples come out very even and repeatably, and the fixture works on bent chainstays. If you press the die 10mm deep into the tube, the resulting dimple is 6mm deep after the spring back, and the tube bends approximately 4 degrees. The fixture design is not perfect. I don't know what I was thinking when I constrained the laser cut brackets with a single hole, allowing the towers to pivot. Also, I got lazy and used dowel pins as pivots. Someone smarter than me would probably use shoulder bolts. I also ordered a new, even bigger die to try out. I think it could spread the dimple over an even larger area and create an even smoother bend. However, as a first pass, I think this was good enough.